हेलो फ्रेंड्स, स्वागत है आपका हमारे इस यूट्यूब चैनल में जिसका नाम है शॉर्ट एंड सुपर फास्ट राइटर्स। आज के इस वीडियो में हम एक डिक्टेशन करेंगे एसएससी स्टेनोग्राफर ग्रेड सी के लिए, और ये बजट स्पीच का एक मैटर है, चैप्टर टू है उसका। तो होप आप अच्छे से लिखेंगे और इसको ट्रांसक्राइब करके कमेंट ज़रूर करिएगा। शुरू करते हैं डिक्टेशन। बी रेडी, 10 सेकेंड्स, 5 सेकेंड्स, स्टार्ट। द न्यू मेट्रो रेल प्रोजेक्ट्स फॉर द टोटल रूट लेंथ ऑफ 300 किलोमीटर्स हैव बीन अप्रूव्ड ड्यूरिंग 2018-19। ऑल्सो ड्यूरिंग 2019 अबाउट 210 किलोमीटर्स मेट्रो लाइन्स हैव बीन ऑपरेशनलाइज्ड। With this, 657 kilometers of metro rail network has become operational across the country. India's first indigenously developed payment ecosystem for transport based on National Common Mobility Card standards was launched by Honorable Prime Minister in March 2019. This will enable people to pay multiple kinds of transport charges, including metro services and toll tax, across the country. This interoperable transport card runs on RuPay card and would allow the holders to pay for their bus travel, toll taxes, parking charges, retail shopping, and even withdrawal money. Phase 2 of FAME scheme, following approval of the cabinet with an outlay of rupees 10,000 crore for a period of 3 years, has commenced from 1st April 2019. The main objective of the scheme is to encourage faster adoption of electric vehicles by way of offering upfront incentive on purchase of electric vehicles and also by establishing the necessary charging infrastructure for electric vehicles. Only advanced battery and registered e-vehicles will be incentivized under the scheme, with greater emphasis on providing affordable and environment friendly public transport options for the common man. The government will carry out a comprehensive restructuring of National Highway Program to ensure that the national highway grid of desirable length and capacity is created using financeable model. After completing the phase 1 of Bharat Mala, in second phase, state will be helped to develop state road networks. We need to develop our inland waterways to shift a significant portion of inland cargo movement from road and rail. This government envisions using the rivers for cargo transportation, which will also help to decongest roads and railways. As part of the Jal Marg Vikas project for enhancing the navigational capacity of Ganga, a multi-modal terminal at Varanasi has become functional in November 2018, and two more such terminals at Sahibganj and Haldia and a navigational lock at Farakka would be completed in 2019-20. The movement of cargo volume on Ganga is estimated to increase by nearly 4 times in the next 4 years. This will make movement of freight passenger cheaper and reduce our import bill. It is estimated that railway infrastructure would need an investment of rupees 50 lakh crores between 2018 to 2030. Given that the capital expenditure outlays of railways are around 1.6 to 1.7 lakh crores per annum, completing even all sanctioned projects would take decades. It is therefore proposed to use public-private partnership to unleash faster development and completion of tracks, rolling stock manufacturing and delivery of passenger freight services. To take connectivity infrastructure to the next level, we will build on the successful model in ensuring power connectivity. One nation, one grid that has ensured power availability to states at affordable rates. I propose to make available a blueprint this year for developing gas grids, water grids, highways and regional airports. The recommendations of the High-Level Empowered Committee on Retirement of Old and Inefficient Plants and Addressing Low Utilization of Gas Plant Capacity Due to Paucity of Natural Gas will also be taken up for implementation now. Our government launched Ujjwal Discom Assurance Yojana in 2015, aimed at financial and operational turnaround of Discom. Government is examining the performance of the scheme and it will be further improved. We will work with the state governments to remove barriers like cross-subsidy surcharges, undesirable duties on open access sales or captive generation for industrial and other bulk power consumers. Besides these structural reforms, considerable reforms are needed in tariff policy. A package of power sector tariff and structural reforms would soon be announced. It is proposed that several reforms measures would be taken up to promote rental housing. Current rental laws are archaic as they do not address the relationship between the lessor and the lessee realistically and fairly. A model tenancy law will also be finalized and circulated to the states. Large public infrastructure can be built on land parcels held by central ministries and central public sector enterprises all across the country. Though innovative instruments such as joint development and concession, public infrastructure and affordable housing will be taken up. For ease of access to credit for MSMEs, government has introduced providing of loans up to 1 crore for MSMEs within 59 minutes through a dedicated online portal. Under the interest subvention scheme of MSMEs, 350 crores has been allocated for the financial year 2019-20 for 2% interest subvention for all GST registered MSMEs on fresh or incremental loans. Government payments to suppliers and contractors are a major source of cash flow, especially to SMEs and MSMEs. Investment in MSMEs will receive a big boost if these delays in payments are eliminated. Government will create a payment platform for MSMEs to enable filing of bills and payment thereof on the platform itself. Encouraged by the overwhelming response, the Government of India has decided to extend the pension benefit to about 3 crore retail traders and small shopkeepers whose annual turnover is less than 1.5 crore under a new scheme, namely Pradhan Mantri Karam Yogi Mandhan Scheme. Enrollment into the scheme will be kept simple, requiring only Aadhaar and a bank account, and rest will be on self-declaration. We recognize that investment-driven growth requires access to low-cost capital. It is estimated that India requires investments averaging 20 lakh crores every year, USD 300 billion a year. A number of measures are proposed to enhance the sources of capital for infrastructure financing. A credit guarantee enhancement corporation, for which regulations have been notified by the RBI, will be set up in 2019-20. An action plan to deepen the market for long-term bonds, including for deepening markets for corporate bonds, repos, credit default swaps, etc., with specific focus on infrastructure sector, will be put in place. It is proposed to permit investments made by FPIs in debt securities issued by infrastructure debt fund, non-bank finance companies, to be transferred to any domestic investor within the specified lock-in पीरियड. सो ये था दोस्तों डिक्टेशन. होप आपने अच्छे से लिखा होगा. आपने किस तरह से लिखा है इसको ट्रांसक्राइब करके कमेंट करके ज़रूर बताइए. इस तरह के और भी डिक्टेशन अगर आप लिखना चाहते हैं तो आप हमारे प्लेलिस्ट पर जा सकते हैं, वहाँ कई सारे डिक्टेशन अवेलेबल हैं. और आपने अपना टाइम लगाया इसके लिए थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग.